Please do not forget to subscribe the channel and please press the bell icon.
Good morning, dear students. In the last class, we have learnt the concept of polynomials, definition, types of polynomials, and also meaning of zeros of a polynomial, and how to find out the zeros of a quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of a polynomial. So we'll proceed with this further. So the topic again which we are going to discuss is relationship between zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. Coefficients of a quadratic polynomial. So students, the two relations that we have discussed in the last session, that were the first relation is, so if the quadratic polynomial is dx is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, c is not equal to 0. So with the help of this, we have obtained alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a, and alpha into beta is equal to c upon a. These were the two relations between the zeros and the coefficients of a polynomial, where alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial, a, b, c are the coefficients of x square, x and the constant term respectively. Okay, now we'll solve some more questions. We have already solved one type of question, that is verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of a polynomial. So before proceeding, I'd like to tell you one thing, that is, now let's see some questions based on the nature of zeros here. Nature of zeros. Let's take first case, that is, if two zeros are equal in magnitude, but opposite in sign, if two zeros are equal in magnitude but opposite in sign, मतलब दोनों zero same है लेकिन दोनों का sign अलग अलग है, एक positive है तो एक negative होगा. That is, now in that case we can write beta is equal to minus alpha. So from here, if you transpose alpha to this side, we'll get alpha plus beta is equal to 0. And the formula for alpha plus beta is minus b by a. Minus b by a, minus b upon a is equal to 0. So we get the condition b is equal to 0. So if in any polynomial, if the value of b is 0, then we can say that the two zeros are equal in magnitude but opposite in sign. We can take an example. If you have a polynomial like x square minus 9. X square minus 9. If you are asked the nature of zeros of this polynomial, we can say the zeros are equal in magnitude. Zeros are equal in magnitude but opposite in sign. Okay. We'll solve some more questions based on this. That is, if two zeros are equal in magnitude but opposite in sign, the condition is b is equal to 0. Let's take another condition. If two zeros are reciprocal of each other. If two zeros are reciprocal of each other, case 2, if two zeros are reciprocal of each other. When we say reciprocal of each other, if one zero is alpha, the other zero will be 1 upon alpha. So from here, we can say beta is equal to 1 upon alpha. Beta is equal to 1 upon alpha. So when we transpose alpha to this side, so we'll get the condition alpha into beta is equal to 1. And alpha beta is equal to C upon A. So C upon A is equal to 1. So we'll get C is equal to A. So when two zeros are reciprocal of each other, then in that case the condition is C is equal to A. Okay, earlier zero is equal in magnitude but opposite in sign, B is equal to zero. Zeros are reciprocal of each other, then we get C is equal to A. Now let's discuss if zeros are given, how to find out the quadratic polynomial. So to find the quadratic polynomial when zeros are given, to find the quadratic polynomial when zeros are given. This is very important question. To find a quadratic polynomial when zeros are given, so in that case we'll write the polynomial like this: px is equal to x square minus sum of zeros multiplied by x plus product of zeros. Sum of zeros multiplied by x plus product of zeros. So for example, if 2 and 3 are the zeros, 2 and 3 are the zeros, now polynomial will be equal to x square minus sum of zeros 2 plus 3 x plus product of zeros 2 into 3. So here we get x square minus 5x plus 6. This is the polynomial whose zeros are 2 and 3. Another example let's take. If the zeros are 1 upon 2 and 2 upon 3. 1 upon 2 and 2 upon 3. Now first, when we solve this, let's take alpha is equal to 1 by 2, beta is equal to 2 upon 3. So first we'll find out sum, then product, and then write the polynomial. So here we get alpha plus beta is 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3. LCM is 6, 3 plus 4. So here we get 7 upon 6, and product alpha into beta 1 upon 2 into 2 upon 3, which can be written as 2 by 6, or we can also write it as 1 upon 3. Now let's write the polynomial. So px will be equal to, px is equal to x square minus 7 upon 6x plus 1 upon 3. Either this can be the answer, or when we take the LCM, 1 by 6 here, this is 6x square minus 7x plus 2 by taking the LCM here. Or it can also be written as constant k, 1 by 6 is replaced by k, so constant k multiplied by 6x square minus 7x plus 2. All these three answers are correct for this particular question. So whenever we get a Yet the sum and product in fractions will simplify it by taking the LCM, and the constant here can be replaced by k. So this way we can find out the polynomial when zeros are given, or directly sum and product of zeros is given, as it is given in question number 2 of exercise 2.2. Like in exercise 2.2, you may find the sum is given. We have one example which is related to similar to NCERT exercise 2.2 question number 2. It is similar to this one. Find the quadratic polynomial when sum is given as minus 1 upon 2 and product of zeros is given as sum of zeros minus 1 upon 2, product of zeros 3 upon 4. So directly here sum is given, product is given. So we'll directly write the polynomial Px is equal to x square minus sum of zeros minus 1 upon 2 into x plus product of zeros, that is 3 upon 4. Or we can take LCM here. So LCM will be 4, that is 4x square minus minus plus 4 divided by 2 is 2, 2 into x, that is 2x plus 3. Or it can also be written as k into 4x square plus 2x plus 3. So this is your final answer. So with the help of this example, you can easily solve the questions of exercise 2.2 question number 2. Okay, we'll upgrade this one. Before moving to the next question, we'll discuss the concept of symmetric functions. Symmetric functions. Now let's discuss what do you mean by symmetric functions. Symmetric functions. Symmetric functions, or let's write expressions. Symmetric expressions in terms of alpha and beta, in terms of alpha and beta, that is only two variables we are taking here. Symmetric functions, alpha and beta are the zeros of a given polynomial, standard polynomial. So symmetric functions are those functions in which the degree of each term is same. For example, if I write simply alpha square plus beta square, see, degree of alpha, power of alpha is 2, power of beta is 2. Degree of first term is 2, degree of second term is also equal to 2. So this is a symmetric function. Secondly, if I write alpha square plus 6 alpha beta plus beta square, again it is a symmetric function because power of alpha is 2. Here degree of this term, when we have the product of two variables, then in that case the degree of the term is equal to sum of their powers. So here the degree of this term is also 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. Power 1 plus power 1, that is equal to 2. For this term degree is 2, for this term degree is also equal to 2. So we observe that degree of each term is same. Therefore this is a symmetric expression. Another example we can take, alpha square beta, alpha cube plus alpha square beta plus alpha beta square plus beta cube. Again we observe here degree of each term, first term degree is 3, next term the degree is 2 plus 1, again it is equal to 3. Here the degree is 1 plus 2, which is again equal to 3, and for this term again the degree is equal to 3. So degree of each term is same. Therefore this is also an example of symmetric function. Another one we can take, that is 1 upon alpha and 1 upon beta. 1 upon alpha and 1 upon beta, or you can also take it as alpha upon beta and beta upon alpha. So in all these type of expressions, we observe that degree of each term is same, hence this type of functions are known as symmetric functions. Okay, so we'll be clubbing here two type of questions, two variety of questions. First we'll also learn how to find out the value of symmetric functions, and then we'll also learn how to find the quadratic polynomial if alpha and beta are the zeros of a given polynomial. So first let's see how to find out the values of such type of symmetric functions. Here the identities will be used, and the most important identities that will be used here, to solve such type of questions. The first one is alpha square plus beta square. Alpha square plus beta square. Remember, all the symmetric expressions are to be written in the form of alpha plus beta and alpha beta. So alpha square plus beta square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. Alpha square plus beta square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. Another one which we'll be taking here, alpha cube plus beta cube. Alpha cube plus beta cube, that is alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 alpha beta alpha plus beta. Alpha cube plus beta cube is equal to alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 alpha beta alpha plus beta. Third one, alpha minus beta whole square. Alpha minus beta whole square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta. Alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta. So these are the relations which we are going to use here. Alpha square minus beta square, that is simply equal to alpha plus beta into alpha minus beta. If it is alpha cube minus beta cube, then it is simply equal to alpha minus beta whole cube plus 3 alpha beta alpha minus beta. So basically these three identities are used here to find out the values of symmetric functions. Right, now let's discuss some questions here, examples here, to find out the values of some symmetric functions, and then we'll move on to the next question. The example number one, that is if alpha and beta are the zeros of, if alpha and beta are the zeros of a polynomial Px is equal to 2x square minus 5x plus 3. Find the value of the first one, alpha square plus beta square. Alpha square plus beta square minus alpha beta. Second one, alpha upon beta plus beta upon alpha. Third one, alpha cube plus beta cube. Fourth one is alpha square upon beta plus beta square upon alpha, and the fifth one is 2 alpha plus 3 beta into 3 alpha plus 2 beta. Okay, so to solve this question, we need not factorize this. We don't have to find out the value of alpha and beta. Alpha or beta nahi find karna hai bachcho. हमें सिर्फ ये रिलेशंस का यूज करना है. सो लेट्स सॉल्व. let's solve. I'll write these expressions by the side here so that we can remember it and we'll solve it further. So here the given polynomial I'm writing here, Px is equal to 2x square minus 5x plus 3, and we have to find out the values of alpha square plus beta square minus alpha beta. This is first one. Second one is alpha upon beta plus beta upon alpha. Third one is alpha cube plus beta cube. Fourth one is alpha square upon beta plus beta square upon alpha. And the last one is 2 alpha plus 3 beta into 3 alpha plus 2 beta. Okay, so now as it is given in the question, that so the solution starts here. Px is equal to 2x square minus 5x plus 3. Let's compare this with standard form. Value of a is 2, b is minus 5, c is 3. We have alpha plus beta equal to minus b upon a. That is minus 5 upon 2. So we get here 5 upon 2, that is the value of alpha plus beta. Secondly, alpha beta is equal to c upon a. Value of c is 3, a is 2. So alpha beta is equal to 3 upon 2. We'll be using these two values to find out the values of given symmetric functions. Let's solve the first one. Very simple one. Alpha square plus beta square minus alpha beta. So see here, for this we have written the identity right now. That is, alpha square plus beta square is alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. Aur ye minus alpha beta pehle se hai, to ye likha hai. Finally ye ho gaya alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta minus alpha beta. ये हो गया माइनस 3 अल्फा बीटा. अब हम यहाँ पर अल्फा प्लस बीटा और अल्फा बीटा की वैल्यू रखेंगे. अल्फा प्लस बीटा की वैल्यू है 5 अपॉन 2. दिस इज 5 अपॉन 2 स्क्वायर माइनस 3 इनटू अल्फा बीटा की वैल्यू है 3 अपॉन 2. सो दैट इज 25 अपॉन 4 माइनस 9 अपॉन 2. दैट इज 25 माइनस 18, that is 7 upon 4 is your answer. Right? Very simple one. You just need to remember the identities. Second one, alpha upon beta plus beta upon alpha. So, pehle to yahan par LCM lena hai, alpha beta. Ab ye ho jayega alpha square plus beta square. Alpha beta. तो बीटा से डिवाइड किया, बीटा से बीटा कैंसिल हो गया, बचा अल्फा. अल्फा इनटू अल्फा, अल्फा स्क्वायर. ऐसे ही अल्फा बीटा को अल्फा से डिवाइड किया, अल्फा अल्फा कैंसिल हुआ, बीटा बच गया, बीटा इनटू बीटा हो गया बीटा स्क्वायर. अब न्यूमरेटर में आइडेंटिटी लगा देते हैं. अल्फा प्लस बीटा होल स्क्वायर माइनस 2 अल्फा बीटा होल अपॉन अल्फा बीटा. अब देखिए, इंटेलिजेंट लोग अल्फा बीटा यहाँ पे काट देंगे. ये नहीं कटेगा भाई, क्योंकि यहाँ पे माइनस का साइन है. ओके, इसलिए ये नहीं कटेगा. तो यहाँ पर अब हम वैल्यूज रखेंगे. अल्फा प्लस बीटा की वैल्यू है हमारे पास 5 अपॉन 2. सो इट इज 5 अपॉन 2 होल स्क्वायर माइनस 2. अल्फा बीटा की वैल्यू थी 3 अपॉन 2 अपॉन 3 अपॉन 2. अब इसको सॉल्व कीजिए. 25 अपॉन 4, 2 से 2 ये कैंसिल हो सकता है, माइनस 3 बाय 1 अपॉन 3 बाय 2. सो दैट बिकम्स 25 माइनस 12 13 अपॉन 4 अपॉन 3 अपॉन 2। तो इसको हम लिख सकते हैं बच्चों 13 अपॉन 4 इंटू 2 अपॉन 3, 2 1s are 2 2s are, so your answer is 13 upon 6. So simply, very simple, we need to use the identities, remember the identities and solve the questions. C part, alpha cube plus beta cube. इसको देखिए दो तरीके से कर सकते हैं, इसको आप दो तरीके से कर सकते हैं। यहाँ से इसको हम एक तो ये लिख सकते हैं alpha plus beta into alpha square plus beta square minus alpha beta। अब यहाँ पर ऊपर देखिएगा आपने alpha square plus beta square minus alpha beta की वैल्यू निकाली थी ऑलरेडी, alpha plus beta की वैल्यू भी आपके पास है, तो alpha plus beta हो गया 5 upon 2 और इसकी वैल्यू फर्स्ट पार्ट से हमने निकाली थी 7 upon 4, so that comes out to be 35 upon 8. This value we have written from part 1 and this we have already calculated. This is one way. And the other way which we can do it is we simply apply the identity. Identity laga do alpha plus beta ka whole cube minus 3 alpha plus beta. Either this or this. तो यहाँ पे जब मैंने आइडेंटिटी लगाई, अब मैं वैल्यूज रखूंगा 5 अपॉन 2 का होल क्यूब माइनस 3 इंटू 3 अपॉन 2 इंटू 5 अपॉन 2, तो यहाँ से हो गया 125 अपॉन 8 माइनस 5 3 जा 15 3 जा 45 अपॉन 4। एलसीएम लेंगे यहाँ पर तो यहाँ से आ जाएगा 125 माइनस 90 अपॉन 8, दैट कम्स आउट टू बी 35 अपॉन 8। दोनों में से किसी भी तरीके से सॉल्व किया जा सकता है, ठीक है। डी पार्ट, डी पार्ट, अगेन डी पार्ट, वेरी सिंपल वन। डी, डी इज अल्फा स्क्वायर अपॉन बीटा प्लस बीटा स्क्वायर अपॉन अल्फा। तो यहाँ भी हम एलसीएम लेंगे बच्चों, अल्फा बीटा एलसीएम हो गया। यहाँ पे आपको क्या मिलेगा, अल्फा क्यूब प्लस यहाँ पे क्या मिलेगा, बीटा क्यूब। अब अल्फा प्लस बीटा, अल्फा क्यूब प्लस बीटा क्यूब, यहाँ पर आइडेंटिटी लगाइएगा अल्फा प्लस बीटा होल क्यूब माइनस 3 अल्फा प्लस बीटा और होल अपॉन अल्फा बीटा, ठीक है। तो अब ये अल्फा प्लस बीटा होल क्यूब मतलब 5 अपॉन 2 का होल क्यूब माइनस 3 इंटू 3 अपॉन 2 इंटू 5 अपॉन 2 होल अपॉन 3 अपॉन 2, मतलब ये हो गया 125 अपॉन 8 माइनस 125 अपॉन 8 माइनस 45 अपॉन 4 अपॉन 3 अपॉन 2 और एलसीएम लेंगे तो आएगा 35 अपॉन 8 अपॉन 3 अपॉन 2, दैट इज 35 अपॉन 8 इंटू 2 अपॉन 3, 2 1s are 2 4s are, सो योर आंसर इज 35 अपॉन 12। बच्चों यहाँ पर देखिए आप अल्फा क्यूब प्लस बीटा क्यूब की वैल्यू हमने ऑलरेडी थर्ड पार्ट में कैलकुलेट की थी, वो भी हम डायरेक्ट रख सकते थे यहाँ पर, ये 35 अपॉन 8 अपॉन 3 अपॉन 2 डायरेक्ट ये स्टेप आ जाएगी आपकी। तो यहाँ पर ये हमने कैलकुलेट किया अल्फा स्क्वायर अपॉन बीटा प्लस बीटा स्क्वायर अपॉन अल्फा। नाउ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वन द लास्ट पार्ट, दैट इज 2 अल्फा प्लस 3 बीटा इंटू 3 अल्फा प्लस 2 बीटा, 2 अल्फा प्लस 3 बीटा इंटू 3 अल्फा प्लस 2 बीटा, ओके। तो इसमें सबसे पहले तो आप मल्टीप्लाई कर लीजिए पूरा, 2 अल्फा इंटू 3 अल्फा हो गया 6 अल्फा स्क्वायर प्लस 2 अल्फा इंटू 2 बीटा हो गया 4 अल्फा बीटा, 3 बीटा इंटू 3 अल्फा इज 9 अल्फा बीटा, 3 बीटा इंटू 2 बीटा इज 6 बीटा स्क्वायर। तो यहाँ से आपको मिला 6 alpha square plus 6 beta square plus 13 alpha beta. अब यहां से मैं दो तरीके से कर सकता हूं, या तो हम इसको ऐसा कर लें, 6 कॉमन लिया, अल्फा स्क्वायर प्लस बीटा स्क्वायर प्लस 13 अल्फा बीटा. ओके, अब यहां पे आइडेंटिटी लगा देते हैं, 6 अल्फा स्क्वायर प्लस बीटा स्क्वायर, अल्फा प्लस बीटा का होल स्क्वायर माइनस 2 अल्फा बीटा प्लस 13 अल्फा बीटा. ओके, और दिस बिकम 6 अल्फा प्लस बीटा होल स्क्वायर माइनस 12 अल्फा बीटा प्लस 13 अल्फा बीटा. राइट, इसका मतलब यहां से हमें मिल गया जो फर्स्ट पार्ट हमें मिल रहा है, फर्स्ट वाले मेथड से हमने जब किया तो ये आया इक्वल टू 6 अल्फा प्लस बीटा होल स्क्वायर प्लस अल्फा बीटा. दिस इज वन वे. ओके, नाउ विल पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ अल्फा प्लस बीटा. सो इट इज 6 इंटू 5 बाय 2 का स्क्वायर प्लस 3 अपॉन 2, 6 इंटू 25 अपॉन 4 प्लस 3 अपॉन 2, 2 3 जार 2 2 जार, दिस इज 75 प्लस 3, दैट इज 78 अपॉन 2, सो योर आंसर इज 39. सेकेंड मेथड, दूसरा तरीका, इसी को देखिएगा. हमें फाइंड करना था यहां पर, ये था हमारे पास 6 अल्फा स्क्वायर प्लस 6 बीटा स्क्वायर प्लस 13 अल्फा बीटा. अब 13 को मैं ब्रेक कर देता हूं मल्टीपल ऑफ 6 प्लस द रिमेनिंग वन, तो ये हो जाएगा 6 अल्फा स्क्वायर प्लस 6 बीटा स्क्वायर प्लस 12 अल्फा बीटा प्लस अल्फा बीटा. यहां से मैं 6 कॉमन निकालता हूं, अल्फा स्क्वायर प्लस बीटा स्क्वायर प्लस 2 अल्फा बीटा प्लस अल्फा बीटा. अब ये हमारी आइडेंटिटी बन गई, 6 अल्फा प्लस बीटा का होल स्क्वायर प्लस अल्फा बीटा. देखिए ये वाली स्टेप आ गई आपकी. अब आप मेथड नंबर 1 की तरफ प्रोसीड करेंगे. राइट, सो बोथ द वेज यू कैन सॉल्व इट. द सिंपल ओनली कॉन्सेप्ट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इज व्हेन अ पॉलीनोमियल इज गिवन, इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी टू फैक्टराइज दिस एंड गेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ अल्फा एंड बीटा, क्योंकि गलती ज्यादातर बच्चे करते हैं. हो सकता है कि कई बार ये पॉलीनोमियल ऐसा दिया जाए जो कि फैक्टराइज करने में आपको प्रॉब्लम हो रही है, मिडिल टर्म स्प्लिट नहीं हो रहा है, तब हम वहां पे अटक जाते हैं, ब्रेक लग जाता है. तो उसके लिए हमें दूसरा रास्ता अपनाना चाहिए, जो कि हमने पहले बताया है कि आपको इसको फैक्टराइज नहीं करना है. आपको क्या करना है, डायरेक्टली अल्फा प्लस बीटा की वैल्यू लिखना है, अल्फा बीटा की वैल्यू लिखना है, और उसके बाद इसकी हेल्प से, आइडेंटिटीज की हेल्प से हमें सिमेट्रिक फंक्शंस की वैल्यूज कैलकुलेट करना है. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट हियर, वी नीड नॉट फैक्टराइज दिस वन. ओके, राइट, लेट्स टेक सम मोर क्वेश्चंस. See, based on this, now if it is given a very simple question, for what value of p, another question now, for what value of p, for what value of p, minus 4 is the zero of the polynomial, minus 4 is the zero of px equal to x square minus 2x minus x square minus 2x minus 7p plus 3. This is the given polynomial. We have to find out the value of p. See, this statement minus 4 is the zero. Iska matlab hua ki jab hum x ki value minus 4 rakhenge, तो वैल्यू क्या होगी, जीरो. तो एक्स की वैल्यू आपको क्या रखना है, माइनस फोर, माइनस फोर का स्क्वायर माइनस टू इंटू माइनस फोर माइनस सेवन पी प्लस थ्री इक्वल टू जीरो, तो ये हो गया 16 प्लस 8 माइनस 7p माइनस 3 इक्वल टू जीरो, सो वी गेट हियर 24 माइनस 3 21 माइनस 7p इज इक्वल टू जीरो, 7p इक्वल टू माइनस 7p इक्वल टू माइनस 21, सो p इज इक्वल टू माइनस 21 अपॉन माइनस 7 दैट इज 3, so the answer is p is equal to 3. So simply when one value is given as the zero, simply need to put the value of x in the given polynomial and put the and solve, equate it to zero to get the value of the unknown quantity that you have. Okay, then next one more question. If 2 and minus 3, if 2 and minus 3, example number 2, if 2 and minus 3 are the zeros of x square plus a plus 1 x plus b. This is the given polynomial. Okay. Now this question can be solved in two ways. First, now see, very simple method. The first one, 2 and minus 3 are the zeros. We have the formula alpha plus beta is equal to minus coefficient of x upon coefficient of x square minus b by a. तो यहां पर ए भी हमने इसलिए नहीं यूज किया क्योंकि क्वेश्चन में दिया हो, या हम इसको ऐसा लिख लेते हैं माइनस बी बाई अल्फा प्लस बीटा, अल्फा इज इक्वल टू टू है, अल्फा इज इक्वल टू टू, बीटा इज इक्वल टू माइनस थ्री, ए इज वन, बी इज होल ए प्लस वन, सी इज बी. Let's put all the values here. 2 plus minus 3 minus b, that is a plus 1 upon a, that is 1 minus 1 into 1 is equal to minus of a plus 1, minus minus cancel, 1 is equal to a plus 1, so a is equal to 1 minus 1 which is equal to 0. ये आ गई आपके पास एक ही बार, अब बी फाइंड करना, बी के लिए दूसरा रिलेशन लगा दो बच्चों, अल्फा बीटा इक्वल टू सी अपॉन ए, अल्फा बीटा इक्वल टू सी अपॉन ए, अल्फा की वैल्यू थी 2 इंटू माइनस 3 इक्वल टू सी की वैल्यू है b और a इज 1, सो वी गेट b इज इक्वल टू माइनस 6, a is equal to 0, b is equal to minus 6. So this way you can find out the value of a and b. Another method, that is 2 is the 0. So we put x is equal to 2. We have p2 is equal to 0, minus 3 is the 0, therefore p minus 3 is also equal to 0. So let's put x is equal to 2 first. So we get 2 square plus a plus 1 into 2 plus b equal to 0. 4 plus 2a plus 2 plus b equal to 0. B plus 2a plus 6 is equal to 0. Therefore, b is equal to minus 6 minus 2a. Now, b minus 3 is equal to 0. So minus 3 square plus a plus 1 into minus 3 plus b equal to 0. Now here we put the value of b. 9 minus 3a minus 3. plus b is minus 6 minus 2a equal to 0. 9 minus 3, 6, minus 3a, minus 6, minus 2a equal to 0. Plus 6, minus 6 cancel, minus 5a equal to 0, therefore a is equal to 0. And b will be equal to minus 6, minus 2 into 0, that is b is equal to minus 6. So these are two methods to solve this type of question. You can apply whichever you find easy. Right? Then next one. If one zero of the polynomial, if one zero of the polynomial x square minus 4x plus 1 is 2 plus root 3. Find other zero. A very simple question. Again, we'll be using the relationship alpha plus beta or alpha beta. So, solution here. We are given px is equal to x square minus 4x plus 1. From here, we have a is equal to 1. B is equal to minus 4, C is equal to 1. 1 0 is given. Let's take alpha is equal to 2 plus root 3. Alpha is equal to 2 plus root 3. We have to find out the value of beta. So we'll simply apply the concept alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a. No need to factorize. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b upon a. So 2 plus root 3 plus beta equal to minus. Value of b is minus 4 upon 1. So that we have 2 plus root 3 plus beta equal to 4. Therefore beta is equal to 4 minus 2 minus root 3. Hence, beta is equal to 2 minus root 3. Now here, I'd like to tell you a shortcut which you can verify here, that in case of roots like a plus b root x, if a plus b root x is a 0 of px, if a plus b root c is a 0 of px, then other 0 is a minus b root c. So with the help of this, if it is an objective type question, alpha is 2 plus root 3. Therefore, beta will be equal to 2 minus root 3. We can verify it very easily that alpha is 2 plus root 3 and I say beta is equal to 2 minus root 3. See, find out alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is 4. The same is the sum here. Alpha plus beta minus 4 upon minus 1. That is 4. And alpha into beta is 2 square 4 minus 3, that is 1. So alpha into beta c upon a, 1 upon 1, that is equal to 1. Hence, if the 1 0 is a combination of rational and irrational number, then in that case the another zero can be calculated easily by using this shortcut directly. Okay, so for an example, if you have a given polynomial, if one zero is 3 plus 2 root 2, what will be the other zero? Even the polynomial is not given to you. If one zero of a polynomial, if alpha is equal to 3 plus 2 root 2, what will be the value of beta? So in that case, your answer should be 3 minus 2 root 2. Clear? So this is a direct concept which you can apply while solving the multiple choice questions, MCQ, right, which are a part of CBSE exam as well as the competitive exams like NTSC or other Olympiads. Okay, one more question. We have already discussed the concept, this one. That is another example here. That is, if one zero is the reciprocal of the other, if one zero of Px is equal to a square plus 9 x square plus 13x plus 6a plus 13x plus 6a is reciprocal of the other, reciprocal of the other, find a. So we have already discussed the concept just few minutes ago, that if one zero is reciprocal of the other, then the condition that we have proved, that is c is equal to a, we can apply here directly. Or we can also consider one zero is the reciprocal, therefore their product will be equal to 1. That means c upon a is equal to 1, so c is equal to a. Now here the value of c is 6a. In place of c we have 6a, in place of a we have a square plus 9, a square plus 9. So from here we get a square minus 6a plus 9 equal to 0, or a minus 3 whole square is equal to 0, or a minus 3 is equal to 0, therefore a is equal to 3. So this way the relations can be applied directly. These questions, you may have 1 mark questions, 2 mark questions, this type of questions may be asked here in your board exam as well, right? Okay, so with the help of this, please don't forget to subscribe the channel Maths by Pradeep Barde and click on the bell icon. And for any doubt, WhatsApp on my number, that is 9981499527. Like the videos, subscribe them. Thank you.